Hello, we are going to discuss how to format a reference for a scholarly journal article in APA 7th edition format. Let's start by looking at a general template. The reference for a journal article will start with the author, followed by the publication year, the title of the article, the title of the periodical or journal, the journal's volume number, the issue number, the page range, and then a DOI. And we'll talk more about each of these pieces. But first, just a reminder, each item in your reference list must have a corresponding in-text citation. And your reference list should be double-spaced and use a hanging indent. And we'll talk more about hanging indents in just a moment. Your reference list is organized alphabetically by author's last name. And just like with the in-text citations, you use the last name followed by initials for the first and middle name. Now, when you're formatting references with multiple authors, if an article has up to 19 authors, you should list them all. If a source has more than 20 authors, you list the first 19, then an ellipses, then the last author. So if you're citing an article like this one, you'd include all of the authors up to Franceschi, then include ellipses, and then end with the final author, lip, here at the end. This is a lot of work to do by hand, and this alone is a good reason to use a citation management system like RefWorks or Zotero. It'll save you a lot of time. Let's talk about article titles and journal titles. APA has very specific rules about capitalization, particularly when it comes to citing journal articles. The first letter of the first word of the article title is capitalized, as is the first letter of the first word of a subtitle, if there is one, and any proper nouns. Now that's for the article title. When it comes to the title of the journal the article was published in, the first letter of every major word should be capitalized, and the title should also be italicized. Volume, issue number, and page numbers are almost always included in the references for scholarly journal articles. In general, the volume corresponds to the year, and then the issues that are published are numbered sequentially. So a periodical that publishes one issue per month will have 12 issues per year. If we look at the American Journal of Public Health, a journal that is published monthly, we see that the volume for 2020 is volume 110. So every item that the American Journal of Public Health publishes in 2020, we'll have the same volume number. We can also see that the January issue is issue 1, the February issue is issue 2, etc. And in this case, there's a few supplemental or special issues included. And finally, we have the DOI, which stands for Digital Object Identifier. And it is basically an attempt at providing a stable, permanent link to an article. Not all articles have DOIs assigned. If there is a DOI, you can usually find it in the database's record, and you should include it in your citation as a live link, so something that your readers can click on and go back to the original source. If an article doesn't have a DOI, that's okay. When no DOI is available, include a URL back to the article unless you found it by searching a database. So if you found it via a database like PubMed and there's no DOI, that's okay. Just end the reference after the page number. If you found an article on the CDC's website, for instance, then you would want to provide a link back to it. Okay, so let's go to our Purdue Online Writing Lab APA formatted student paper and take a look at the reference list. Note that the reference list starts on its own page with the heading References. And note the hanging indent that we discussed a moment ago. The first line of the reference is flush left, while the following lines are indented a half inch. And here up at the top, we can see another example of a correctly formatted reference list. We have two authors, in this case, combined with the ampersand, the year, the title, and notice the capitalization scheme here, the title of the journal the article was published in, the volume, volume 64, issue 3, comma, page numbers 431 to 441, and then the DOI. Now, the next two references are actually for websites. So you can see that those look a little bit different. Websites will be formatted differently. And let's take a look at a template for just a couple other types of sources other than scholarly journal articles. So here are templates for books, where we, again, have the author's name in the same format, the year of publication, the title of the book, and then the publisher's name. You no longer need the location of the publisher. That's a change with the 7th edition. Then we have our articles, which we've talked a lot about, and our websites. So with websites, you want the last name of the author or responsible party, year, month, date, title of the page, name of the website, and the URL. Not all of this information will always be available. You just have to do your best and do your due diligence to find as much as you can. So I hope this brief introduction to APA formatted references was helpful. You will probably need to refer to the APA manual frequently. It will very likely be an important reference source for you. Another good resource for citing information is the Purdue Online Writing Lab. And you can find a link to the Purdue Online Writing Lab, also known as the Purdue OWL, by going to the library's homepage, usfca.edu/library, hovering over Guides and Tools, selecting Citing Sources, and then scrolling down to Purdue OWL APA Style. Thank you for watching this introduction to APA 7th edition formatted references.